Well, good morning. It's Tuesday morning. We are so blessed to be with you today. And today we want to talk about our words matter. Our words have influence. They have an effect on the people around us. And you know, we're big on anyway talking about the words out of our mouth, yeah, especially about ourselves or what we're going through. But today we want a little bit different slant. We want to talk about how words affect others and how your words matter to other people. The scripture is in Psalms 141, verse 3. God, give me grace to guard my lips from speaking what is wrong. Mm. I like that. That's really a good, great scripture. And then in James 1:19, he says this, my dearest brothers and sisters, take this to heart. Be quick to listen, slow to speak, and be slow to become angry. Amen. Amen. You know, when we become angry or we become mad, many times we say things in anger that we don't really mean, but once they're out there, they're hard to take back, aren't they?
My grandmother used to say, words are like water. Once they spill out, you can't take it back.
Yes.
And she used to also say that scientists tell us that when words go out, they just continue. You can't reel them back in, and the hearer of those words can be affected greatly by what you say.
You know, speaking of words, you know, the power of God puts power in words.
Yes, he
you
does.
Know, because if you go back to Genesis, God demonstrates that with his word, and God said, mm-hmm, you know, and really and truly, I believe God's words are continuing on. You know, they say in space, those words just
That's
continue
right.
on.
Right.
And in our lives, I believe our words also affect the people around us. They can build them up or they can tear them down,
yes,
you know. They can encourage someone or they can discourage someone,
right,
you know. And I believe
that... we all have experienced that in our lives,
yeah,
where people said negative things to us.
Yes.
And we don't... A lot of times we don't remember all the positive things they said. We just remember that negative.
Yeah.
Satan will see to that. He'll make sure you remember the negative because he wants you to feel inferior. He wants you to feel like you don't matter. And you do matter.
You do.
And
yeah.
But people's words do affect you.
You know, just thinking about in your life, think about people who have spoken things over you. I was preaching not too long ago and had mentioned my dad and how even at 70 years old, I can still hear some of the words my dad spoke over me. And it was interesting after the service because the lady had come up to me, she said, I'm the same way. I can still hear the words, you know, and they weren't words that were encouraging, they were detrimental, you know, so our words to others matter as well and what you're saying to them.
Sometimes the people we love the most, we say the meanest things too. I don't know if that's because I guess we think they'll be there tomorrow. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're going to forgive us. They're going to still do it. But you know what? We shouldn't do that to anybody.
No.
And especially those we love. I mean, people in our family or close friends. Instead of tearing them down, we need to build them up with the Word of God. We need to encourage them. We need to be positive. You know, people say that Charles and I are very positive.
We are.
Well, it's a choice.
It is.
It's
every
a choice
day.
We make every
day.
Because I can be negative. He'll tell you, I came from a long line of negative. And so it can get down in you from the way you were brought up. But when I found out the power of my words, I started working on me to change those, renewing my mind to the Word of God, saying things will build people up, not tear them down. I'm not patting myself on the back. I found out that I could be cursing people. And I don't mean cursing like using curse words, but it's just as bad, if not worse,
yes,
because you're putting death and defeat on people that God does not want that going on.
I think James really gives us the solution here, Marcia, when he says, take this to heart, be quick to listen and slow to speak, you know, and sometimes we're... You know, when somebody's talking to us, we're not even listening. We're already thinking about what we're going
right.
to say back to them, you know. And you can't really hear you can't hear somebody and at the same time be thinking. We're just not that smart people, you know. We just don't have that ability. And we need to learn to listen to people. I think if we did, we would curb the words that we speak back to them, you know.
And ask God to let your spirit hear what they're saying.
Yes, yes.
And but you're right. If we would just listen and let them finish, and then let the Spirit of God out of you respond to them, not your flesh or your emotions get in the way. Amen.
Yeah, and that happens with parents and children, with children and parents, you know, friends. Even can even happen at church. So we just encourage you, do what James said. You know, take control of your tongue. James 3 says it's the most unruly part of us. So take control of that. Do what David said. God, Lord, put a guard over my mouth. God bless you. We love you. Have a blessed day today in Jesus' name.